Shalom again. Shalom from Jerusalem. With us today, we have Dr. Emmanuel Navon, specialist on Israel and the Middle East. And he's an author of a very unique book, The Star and the Scepter. Shalom.
Shalom. Nice. Thank
Emmanuel, you, Emmanuel. Great having you with us. Emmanuel, there's no doubt that the Middle East has changed. And actually, the Middle East is changing as we talk very rapidly. Can you elaborate on the Middle East today?
So I think we have to understand that this Middle East was basically created politically by Europe after World War I. These artificial entities were taken over during the Cold War by the two new superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union. And then you had the Iranian Revolution. And the Iranian Revolution was against both the West and the Soviet Union. When the Soviet Union collapsed in 1991, all you had left was the West in the Middle East and Islamism. And eventually, Islamism became a stronger and stronger force in the Middle East. And until today, it is shaping the region. Since Israel's independence in 1948, Israel became the focus of the Arab world. Instead of focusing on themselves, on building their countries, on building democracies and thriving economies, the Arab leaders were only focusing on Israel.
10 years ago, the conflict in the Middle East was Israel, the Palestinian issue, and the Arab world. Today, we see that the Israeli-Palestinian issue is almost a non-issue.
Right. Arab leaders did not want to officially normalize their relation with Israel and benefit from their relation with Israel without some kind of political agreements between Israel and the Palestinians. But this agreement has been unreachable for decades. So today they realize that Israel is not their enemy. In fact, the biggest enemy for the Arab, as far as the Arab countries are concerned, is Iran and its nuclear program. So basically what those leaders are saying is that, you know, we're not going to wait another 30 years before we can benefit from our relation with Israel. And when I say benefit, it's not only the security and intelligence cooperation vis-a-vis Iran. I mean, the economic cooperation, that's also why they...
Why do they need Israel? Why didn't they go to England, France?
Because that's where Israel is the Silicon Valley of the Middle East. They know that Israel is the best ally against the Iranian threat. They know that Israel has the technology that enables you to have sustainable growth when you can no longer rely on natural resources alone. And they also come to realize today and recognize, by the way, and you see it in many social interactions between Jews and Arabs in those countries, they're actually abandoning the propaganda that they used for so many years, saying, well, the Jews don't belong here, it's a foreign people. Those countries, at least, they don't say that anymore. And that, I think, is the real key to peace. People-to-people peace. And that is really a change, a welcome change, and in this peace agreements in the Abraham Accords between Israel and the UAE and other Arab countries.
Do you have a message to the world out there, to Christians around the world?
Well, first of all, we very much appreciate your support and your love for Israel. I want to tell you that this love is mutual. I think we also have a common destiny and a common values to promote, not only in Israel, but also throughout the West. And God willing, together, we will continue to promote those values.
Thank you very much, Dr. Navon. It was a great interview.
Thank you.
It was very
enlightening. It was my pleasure, and a pleasure to be here.
Thank you. And stay with us for another Inside Israel and the Middle East.